Hi, assalamu alaikum. Today we are going to learn on the system of inequalities, in which we are going to combine many inequalities in one graph, and we need to find a shaded region which satisfies the all the inequalities given in the question. Suppose we have this the first question here. We are given with four inequalities here. The first one, which is x greater than negative 1, x plus y is less than 0, y is greater than or equal to x squared minus 4, and also x squared plus y squared is less than or equal to 4. Right, so the first thing that we can do is to write the, let's say we write its equality first. So x equal to negative 1. For the second one, which is y, which is equal to negative x, right? Because actually we have the x plus y equal to 0, and we need to transform this because we know this is actually a straight line, so we can write this as y equal to a negative x. Right, the third one will be a quadratic graph, which is y equal to x squared minus 4, right? And the last one, which is a circle, so x squared plus y squared, which is actually equal to 2 squared, right? So we need to plot this on a graph, so let's just put this in this, right? So all right, please use the ruler because now I don't have the ruler. So this is y-axis, and then I have the what we call x-axis, right? So this is x-axis, all right, something like this. So this is my x-axis, right? This is x-axis. Okay, so the first one, which is x equal to a negative 1, so a negative 1 would be here, alright? If you want to draw it bigger, so you can use this scale, alright? So this is a negative 1. And we know that this is, we know that this is the straight line for the x equal to negative 1, but since it is actually greater than or, greater than negative 1, so meaning that we don't have the equality symbol, we don't have that. So we have to use the dotted line here, all right? So to represent that x, which is greater than negative 1, meaning that the negative 1 is not included, all right? So we know that the region is actually somewhere on this side, okay? So this is the region, okay? All right, so let me just use the biggest one, all right? So this is the region because it's greater than negative 1, right? All these sides, x, which is greater than a negative 1, all right? So okay, something like this. Next, we have to plot the graph for y, which is greater than y equal to negative x. So y, which is equal to negative x, all right? So y, which is a negative x, is something like this, all right? So this is something like, okay, this is y equal to a negative x, okay? Because it has the negative gradient, right? And the gradient is 1, so negative 1, all right? So something like this. So this is my graph for y, which is equal to negative x. But since we have this, we have this one, all right? I need to transform this into y, which is less than negative x, right? So y, which is less than negative x. So I have to use the dotted line in this case, all right? Okay, let me just, right, meaning that we cannot use the full line there, right? Meaning, all right, because we have the y, which is less than negative x. Since y, which is less than negative x, so we have to use the dotted line, all right? Sorry. Okay. This is a straight line, right? Please use the ruler to sketch this dotted line. Okay, so this one goes to this dotted line, all right? Since we want the part where y, which is less than negative x, so of course we need to shade the region which is below this line, so it's all on this line here. Okay, it's all here. Okay, so now we need to find the intersection between the green and also the yellow highlights here, right? So it's all over here because it's less than it. Okay, something there. So this part is not considered, and this part is also not considered, right? Because we want the intersection between the two. And then we have the next one, all right, in which we have this one, y which is greater than or equal to x squared minus 4. So we have to draw the graph for y, which is x squared minus 4. Y is equal to x squared, something like this. But when we have y equal to x squared minus 4, meaning that we have that one will touch at negative 2 and 2, all right? And it is actually y equal to x squared somewhere here, but it is shifted downwards by 4 units. So 1, 2, 3, 4. So this is actually a negative 4. Okay. So your negative 4 is there. And then I'm going to use the green color here. All right. So it must pass through this. Okay. Should we use dotted line? No, because it is actually greater than or equal to. All right. So the equality symbols is there, so you can use the full line to draw this. Graph, right? I'm sorry, because negative positive 2 is not there. Positive 2 here is positive 1, and then positive 2 is here, right? So 1, 2, 3, 4. So negative 4 is somewhere around here. All right, let me just use the green color. Okay, something like this, right? This is my quadratic here, my quadratic graph. Okay, something like this, right? So now, okay, this is my quadratic graph, right? And it is actually the part where now it is greater than, all right? We need to consider the part where it is actually greater than or equal to x squared minus 4. So it is actually all this part, okay? Let me just shade it, all right? Something like this. Okay, somewhere around here. Okay. Somewhere around here is all greater than or equal to x squared minus 4. So we know that the region is actually this part. Okay, this part, right? Okay, yeah, it's now there. All right. But we have the last one, all right, which is which satisfy the inequality for the circle, all right? So we have x squared plus y squared, which is less than or equal to 4, meaning to say that we have, okay, this is, all right, so you have to draw for this circle, but using the full line, not the dotted, because we have the equality there. All right, therefore, we have this one as a negative 2, and this one as positive 1, positive 2. All right, so this is the circle. Okay, all right, so this is the circle. All right. Okay, something like this. So since it is less than or equal to 4, therefore the region is actually somewhere inside this one. So which satisfies all the four the four inequalities. So actually this part only, because this one is less than that slanted line, greater than a negative 1, and therefore it's inside this circle and it's above this that one is quadratic graph. Okay, so you delete this one, right? Delete everything here, right? So this is the region. I'm gonna shade the region. All right, so this is the region, all right, that satisfies all the four all the four inequalities. All right, okay, so we are done with this question. All right, so that's it. But it's you must label, all right? So this is the equation for the that one is for the quadratic graph. So y equal to x squared minus 4. This one x equal to negative 1, this one y equal negative x, and this one will be the x squared plus y squared equal 4. Alright, and then we are done. The final answer should be only the shaded region, alright? Remove everything that was shaded before. Right, that was shaded before is considered as the working. Alright, let's go to the next one. Alright, suppose we have this one. So we have to modify this, all right? So we try to write this as, so 4y, which is actually less than 3x. So this is actually, we have y, which is less than 3 over 4 of x. Okay, 3 over 4x. Alright, this one, we try to modify this one. We have 2y, which is greater than or equal to x minus 2. Alright, so I have this one as y, which is greater than or equal to x over 2 minus 1. Alright, so now this one, no problem. Alright, for this the last one, but it's also no problem. But what we need to draw on the graph is actually, okay, the first one, alright, this is the first one, alright. Y, which is actually equal to 3 over 4x, alright, a straight line. The second one will be the y, which is equal to x over 2 minus 1. Right, the next one will be y, which is equal to 0, y, which is equal to 5, and last one, x equal to 9. Alright, so now let's start plotting this. Alright, we should consider y equal to 5 and x equal to 9. Alright, so it's something like this maybe. Alright, so we have something like this. This is y axis. And sorry, yes, that one is y axis. This one is the x axis. Alright. So this is x axis, right? Now I'm going to label this for x, which is 9. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So that is 9, right? So this is 9, x equal to 9. So I have the straight line, something like this. But we cannot use the full line because it is less than. It does not have the equality symbol. Therefore, we have to use the dotted line to represent the graph and the graph for x, which is equal to 9, right? So I'm gonna label this as x equal to 9. Right, next one, it will be y, which is equal to 0, right? Y, which is equal to 0, is this line, right? So this is y equal to 0. And y equal to 5, alright? So the line y equal to 5 is somewhere around this, alright? So this is my, okay, straight line, y equal to 5, alright? So it's said that it's the shaded region should be in between this, alright? So of course, when we want to shade the region, should be in between this one. It should be in between this, alright? So let me just shade it first. Okay. It will be something like this, and it must satisfy that the region is less, x is less than 9, so x is less than 9 is all over this part. So we have to find the shadow between the two, so we have that intersection there, right? So all right something like this. So we have the intersection part there. All right, next we are going to draw for the this one. Okay, y, which is equal to 3 over 4x. So we should note that the length, which is 3 here, right? And the length here should be 4. All right, so it would be something like this. Okay, all right. This is like 3 over 4. Because y2 minus y1 is actually 3, and x2 minus x1 is actually 4. 3 over 4 is something like that, all right? But we cannot use the full line because we don't have the equality symbols there, right? So we should use the dotted line to connect between these, right? So it must pass through the point 0, the origin point, all right? So it will be something like this, all right? So it must use the dotted line to connect the points, all right? So 3 over 4, okay? So it's something like this. This is the dotted line, all right? So this is the graph for y, which is 3 over 4x, okay? But we need to consider the part where it is actually below that line, right? Where is it below? So in this part only, right? Below, right? We know that that's somewhere around there, okay? So next one, right? Okay, next one will be the last one, which is the graph for y, which is half x minus 1, all right? It must pass through negative 1, right? This is a negative 1. And what do we call? Okay, this is 1 over 2, all right? So it must pass through 2, okay? All right. If you're not sure about this, all right, you can try to substitute, okay, For x-intercept, so y which is equal to 0, so you have x over 2 minus 1 equal to 0. So x minus 2 equal to 0, so and x is equal to 2. For x which is equal to 0, now you have y equal to negative 1. So it plus negative 1 and 2. Right, something like this. But because you have the equality symbol, you can use the full line, not the dotted line. Right, to draw that, alright, so you have something like this. Okay, alright. Okay, that is the line, alright. So you should connect this, a straight line, alright, between this, alright. Something like this. Something like this. Something like this. Alright. Something like this, alright. So that is, but please draw it without, what we call, please smoothly, alright. Now it's not that smooth, alright. So we know that the region is actually greater than, alright, we have the y which is greater than or equal to x over 2 minus 1. So this is the graph, y which is x over 2 minus 1, alright. So it's above this, alright, it's above this one. For that one, which is below this one, alright, below this. Okay, so it's in between this one actually. Okay, alright. So let me just shade the final region, right? Because we must have the final region here. Alright. Okay. So delete this one. Okay. So I have the final region which should be shaded, which is between this. Let me just use a smaller one. Yes. Must satisfies all the four inequalities, so it should be in that. All right, so that is the region. Okay, all right. Now that's the answer. Let's go to the last one. Suppose we have these inequalities. So the first one, we know that is actually a circle with the center positive 2, 3, and the radius is actually 5. All right, so we know that this is the center. It's given by 2, 3, and the radius is actually a 5. From the second equation, sorry, the second inequalities, we can actually write this in the form of, alright, so x plus 1 square, which is less than or equal to negative 6, y minus 2, right? So we can actually transform this into parabola, alright, which is given by x plus 1 square, which is equal to negative 6, y minus 2, because now it's x square, so it's either like this or like this, and y is already positive, or this part is negative, therefore we don't choose this one, we choose this one because it's negative here, right? And we know that the vertex, all right, so the vertex of this parabola is actually given by negative 1, positive 2. Okay, all right. And the last one, alright, so for the last one, which is given by these inequalities, let's just consider, alright, the negative y, which is less than or equal to negative x plus 1, right? So I have y, which is greater than x minus 1. So we can actually sketch the graph for y, which is equal to x minus 1, right? Now we try to plot this, right? So when we try to plot this one, okay, so suppose we have, this is y, alright, 2, 3, alright. Right. 2, 3. 8, right, so 4, 0. Right, suppose I have my, what do we call, my x-axis here, alright? Alright. So the center of this circle, let's just draw the circle first, right? The center of this circle is actually given by 2, 3. So 2, 3 is somewhere around here. Therefore, all right, so let me just bring down the what x axis a little bit below, all right, because I want to have that one, all right. Okay, all right, x, all right, so this is 2 and 3 is here, all right, so this is the center and the radius is 5, therefore I have something like, all right, so plus 5 you get here. And then that one will be here, that one will be 3, 5 is here and also here, right? So, and my circle should be a full line because it's equality is there, right? So we have a full circle there, right? All right, something like this, right? Okay, And then we have something like this. All right. It must pass that actually. All right. Okay, I'm sorry for drawing it. All right. Okay, not bad. Because I'm using the iPad for drawing this, right? Okay, so we have this one, right? Now, we need to consider the second one, all right? Suppose if you want to consider the line here, which is y, which is given by x minus 1. So, x minus 1 means it must pass the negative 1. So, the gradient is positive 1, so it must pass through this, right? So, it's something like this. But is it in full line or dotted line? All right, check back. The inequality has the equality symbol there. Therefore, we have to use the full line. Alright, so let me just label this as of x minus 2 square plus y minus 3 square equal to 25. So this line is actually y equal to x minus 1. Alright, now let me just shade the region first. For the circle, it's less than, so it should be inside. So it should be everything inside this, what do we call this circle, right? Now we have the right, the second one, which is y, which is greater than equal to x minus 1, so it's above this line, so everything above that line will be considered as the region, right? So everything here, right, must satisfy this region. All right, let me do it faster. All right, so we got the shadow region, which is given by the green region there, but we have the last one which need to be considered, which is the this inequality, right, in which it has the right, it is in the form of this. All right, so we should know that the vertex is actually a negative 1, 2. So negative 1, 2 is here, so that is the vertex. So you should have like an inequality there, right? Something like this. Okay, all right. If you are not sure which values of x will it pass, so we know that this value is 0. You can find by solving that. All right, so something like that. This is my x plus 1 square, which is equal to negative 6 y minus 2. Since the inequality is less than or equal to, so it should be at this region, all right, everything here. But you must shade only on the part where it is actually green here, all right? So the final answer would only be that. Okay, so this is the final answer, right? So this is your shaded region. It's above that line, inside the circle, and below that parabola. All right, so that's the region. Okay, so that's basically solving this type of questions for inequalities. I hope you get the idea. All right, so that's it. Thank you for watching this video.